Welcome to the Boat Deck Measurement Continuing PhotoModeler Work Tutorial. This video continues from and expands on the Boat Deck Measurement PhotoModeler Work video. This video will cover adding a panel on a different surface, editing outlines, reviewing outlines on other photos, correcting a wrong surface, verifying using check measurements, tracing raised objects, using image enhance, exporting a 2D flattened file, handling panels on angled surfaces. As shown in the previous video, the project has one outlined floor panel. We will add to the project, outlining a second panel on the seat here. Open a photo showing a straight-on view of the panel. Select the points on the panel and create a best fit plane. In the 3D view, we can see this plane is at a different height than the one defining the floor. Open the properties pane to offset the new plane by -4 mm to account for the thickness of the rubber targets. This seating area does not have an existing non-skid panel to outline. Instead, we will trace near the edge to define a brand new panel. Switch to Surface Points Curve mode to mark the panel on this new surface. Clicking to create the first surface draw points prompts to use the closest surface. When there are multiple surfaces in a project, you need to make sure the outlining is done on the correct one. In this case, Surface 2. Use the right-click Create Corner Point option to create a new segment. Straight lines can be defined using a segment with only two points. Use corner points when switching between straight segments and curved regions, or when the curve makes sharp transitions. If a point is misplaced while drawing the curve, right-click and choose Remove Last Curve Point. Points and curves can also be adjusted after the outline is created. We'll make some intentional drawing mistakes, and we'll demonstrate editing once the outline is finished. In this area, we would like to have straight lines, but creating them as a single curve results in a bend. Click on the first point to close the outline, then right-click and choose End Curve Draw. To fix the mistakes, we start by switching to Select mode. Select and drag the points to the desired locations. Selected points can also be removed by using the Delete key. When creating this area, we could have created straight segments using the Surface Points Line mode, or using the Curve Corner Point option. Instead of deleting them and recreating using one of those methods, first switch to Surface Points Curve mode and right-click on the points to convert them to corner points. The other right-click edit tool is Remove Point from Curve. This option removes the point from the curve, but keeps it. In this case, the point that was removed from the curve can be selected and deleted. If you right-click on a curve instead of a point, a new point can be inserted to refine the curve shape. Use the Insert Point in Curve menu option. The new outline can be seen in the 3D view. Our new panel is on a plane parallel to the first one, but at a different height. Later, we will see how a 2D export will flatten these to the same height. Review the 3D outline on photos from different angles to make sure it lines up correctly. This outline lines up correctly, but later we will show a case where it does not. Next, we add a third panel located on a different surface. These 6 points define the correct surface for the panel. But as an example of the impact of an incorrect surface, we will also select some points off the surface. Holding down Shift adds to the selection set. Another way to select a non-rectangular set of points is using Region Select mode. Use left clicks to create an outline of the region. Double-click or right-click and choose Select Region to select all the objects inside the defined area. Fitting a best fit plane to this point set shows a questionable fit warning. This warning explains there is no flat surface that comes close to all of the points selected. This warning indicates the panel is not flat and should be broken up into smaller, flat sections. For this example, we will ignore this warning to show the consequences. The 3D view shows the angled plane created. Open a top-down view of the panel to outline. Our tracing will be done on the newly created and angled surface number 3. Viewing the newly created outline on a photo from a different angle shows that it does not line up correctly. The alignment is wrong on all photos viewed from any other angle. In the 3D view, you can see why. The outline uses the incorrectly defined surface that does not match the actual panel. To fix this, define the correct surface. Select the points on the panel and create a best fit plane using them. The pop-up in the corner shows the fit is much better. Select this new surface and use the Properties pane to offset it -4 mm to account for the thickness of the rubber targets. To associate the outline with the correct surface, select it and use the Properties pane to assign the correct surface ID. The outline now uses the correct surface. And the alignment on other photos is now correct. To verify a project solution, the measure pane can be used to compare against measurements taken on-site. Open the measurement pane and select objects to see measurement information. For example, the distance between these two hinges is about 272 millimeters. Selecting a target, holding Shift, and selecting a second one shows the distance between the two targets is approximately 1 meter. These values can be compared to measurements taken on the boat for verification. We'll revisit a hinge that was marked on this last surface. When you're outlining raised objects, like these hinges, make sure to mark the area it intersects the panel. For example, in this photo, you can see where the front side of the hinge intersects the panel, but the back side is obscured. The back side would need to be marked on a different photo where the panel intersection is visible. If you can see the whole intersection outline between the object's bottom surface and the panel surface in a top-down photo, you may be able to trace all of its outline in that one photo. In some cases, when the area of interest is hard to see, Image Enhance can be used. Adjust the sliders to enhance the image. For example, changing the gamma can make it easier to see overly bright or shadowed areas. The Reset button restores the image to its original state. The three outlines that were created earlier in the video can now be exported. A full 3D export would keep all the outlines at their different heights. Choosing a 2D export means the outlines will be flattened to a single plane. Typically, the work in CAD done on boat decks is done in two dimensions. That is why flattening is important. By default, the flattening is done to the XY plane, defined by the A letter sheet, but that can be adjusted on the Settings tab. If the outlines are drawn on surfaces that are not parallel to the flattening plane, other techniques or settings should be used. One of these settings will be demonstrated next. Viewing the exported file in a CAD program shows the flattened result. All panels are at the same height, as we would expect in a 2D drawing. Here is another example of a project with multiple panels. As before, the panels are at different levels. However, the bottom panel is also at a different angle. This surface is not parallel to the plane defined by letter sheet A. Flattening this to the XY plane may not give the result you want. There are two solutions. First, each panel could be done as separate projects. With sheet A placed on the panel, each project will have a different XY flattening plane. The second solution, to be used if the panels are outlined in one project, like the project shown, is to use the surface planes flattening option. With this option, each surface is treated as a separate 2D flattened plane. This way, the angle of the plane does not matter. However, the relative position of each flattened group will not be retained. This means the position and distance between each surface, shown here as colored areas, will not match the real world. But the shape and distances within each panel or surface will be correct. Viewing the exported 2D file in a CAD program shows the flattened result. All panels are at the same height. In summary, this video covered creating and outlining a panel on a second surface, adjusting and editing an outline, reviewing outlines on other photos, correcting what happens if the wrong surface is used for tracing, verifying a project using check measurements, tracing raised objects, using the Image Enhance tool, exporting 2D results to CAD, and how to work with angled surfaces.